Magandang tanghali, Malacañang Press Corps. Dalawang mahalagang ahensya sa pagbangon natin galing sa pandemya, Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office at saka ang PhilHealth. May mahalaga po silang announcement ngayong araw na ito na makakatulong dito sa ating economic recovery. Boss Mel?
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Today, the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office is going to remit its share to the national government, national treasury, in fact, and which will give the Philippine, the PhilHealth, no, more funds to support the universal health care law. This is just the first among the remittances that we will do, because under the law, 40% of our charity fund will have to go to the universal health care. I forgot the most important thing. It's 2.5 billion. 2.5 billion pesos to help finance the universal health care. And this is over and above the taxes that we pay. So apart from the taxes that we give to the Department of Finance, we still have to give this the charity fund, from our charity fund, 2.5 billion.
Ilan ang taxes? May idea kayo, Boss Mel, ilan ang taxes na binabayaran? Pero you have income, you have VAT,
yeah,
and
we have all the taxes, including documentary taxes.
Stamp. So on top of that, meron tayong more than 2 billion na nire-remit sa universal healthcare through PhilHealth. Madam?
Yes, thank you very much for inviting us here. In behalf of our OIC President, Attorney Eli Santos, who is now in Congress for a budget hearing, we are very happy to be the recipient of these funds from PCSO. We have lined up several benefits for the use of these funds. These funds will be transmitted to the Treasury and will be remitted to PhilHealth through a national subsidy for benefit improvement. So it's a different subsidy from the usual GIA subsidy to PhilHealth for the premiums of indirect contributors. This fund is specifically for benefit improvement and will not in any way be used for any admin expense. So we're very happy that we will be receiving these funds because it will translate to better financial protection of all our members. Thank you.
May katanungan po ba kayo sa ating dalawang ahensya?
Eden Santos, Net25.
Hello. Good afternoon po. Sa PhilHealth po, yung po bang 2.5 billion pesos ay gagamitin doon sa mga hindi pa nababayarang mga COVID expenses po ng mga pasyente way back before pa?
Hindi po. As we said, the funds from PCSO will be a special fund in the coffers of PhilHealth, and it will be used only specifically for benefit improvement. And in fact, we'll be coming out with a medium-term expenditure plan for these funds from PAGCOR and PCSO, with, of course, in the with the coordination and approval also of the two agencies.
Ano-ano po mga benefits ito na pagkakagastosan po nung 2.5 billion pesos?
Some of them are review of our existing case rate para mapataas ang case rate at mas ma-improve yung ating support value. Doon rin sa ating dialysis para ma-increase ang sessions ng dialysis for our dialysis patients. Meron rin tayo mga orthopedic benefits that's planned for that. And our Z benefits or yung catastrophic benefits namin, i-review po rin natin yon and try to increase the support value also of these conditions. These conditions were identified because most of the assistance that PCSO were giving were in the area of these benefits. And therefore, we agreed to look at all these case rates and Z benefits for use of that fund.
So, hindi po kasama ang COVID dito? yung mga COVID patients, ganyan.
We are paying for COVID benefits through our existing funds.
Thank you po.
Salamat din po.
Next question, Ms. Evelyn Quiroz.
For GM Robles, first time po itong 2.5 billion na remittance nyo since umupo po kayo sa PCSO.
Yeah, this is the first time under my watch.
So ito po ba yung 2.5 is part of the remittance po ng mga STL operators, yung mga franchise holders natin sa buong Pilipinas?
Yes, combined na ito with the Lotto and the STL funds. We have a charity fund. Mayroon kasi ano eh. Allocation from the all the from the gross income, you have about 35% to charity, and from there 40% of that goes to the universal health care law.
So ito pong fund na ito, since na mention niyo from STL operations, meron po ba kayong report na natanggap na may mga STL franchise holders po na hindi pa nakakapag-operate sa bansa?
Oh yeah, meron. Meron yan. It's a normal occurrences.
So ano po yung direktiba dito ng PCSO? Para kasi po kung legal po yung franchise holder sila, makakapag-operate po sila at the same time, mare-remit po nila yung inaasahan nating remittance.
Medyo mahabang kwento lang. No? But the short and long of it, if you apply for a STL franchise, you give a feasibility study, and we presume that the applicant can operate. So, you upon given the permit to operate, we will give you a certain number of days for you to operate and remit. Pag hindi, then it shows na hindi ka ready and you are not qualified to be an agent. Actually, we call them agents.
Thank you, sir.
Next question, Vance Fernandez, please, tonight.
Being in the PCSO, sir, have you looked on this mga illegal STL or mga weteng na illegal under your watch now?
Yeah, I will answer this, but if you could direct also your question sana on the assistance, you know, because this is really, but yes, I will answer this. Yes. We have it is a fact that we have a lot of illegal operations, and we're doing our best to contain them because, yes, they directly affect our contribution to the universal health care. Rest assured, we are working because we don't have police powers, but we are using a lot of persuasion and legal moves to curtail the operations of the illegal weteng. Among them, yung bukis, merong peryahan ng bayan, no? The lot. Alam nyo naman sa Pilipinas, kahit basketball, tinatayaan eh. So there is a proliferation, and we are doing our best to have this prevented para naman yung legal STL, which is paying their who are paying their taxes and in fact contributing to the coffers of the PhilHealth, can operate and proliferate.
Sir, on another issue, sabi niyo yung mga assistants, have you looked on this ano yung mga medical assistance and financial assistance you have given? Mga ilan na po to? How much?
I don't have the figures now, but I will tell you they've been reduced dramatically because of the imposition of, for example, doc stamps. No, just for in context, prior to 2019, our budget for charity is 9 billion. No, now our budget for the whole year is only 900 million. So it has dropped dramatically. It is one-tenth, including what we give. No, kaya yung tiran lang sa for charity is less than a billion.
Sir, may mga nagdereklamo, sir, sa mga online kasi they're asking for some medical assistance. pwede silang, let's say, pumunta personal sa inyong office?
Yeah, they can email me because right now talagang dinidiscourage natin yung face-to-face. Yung face-to-face, yung pila. And then they can complain. And yes, they have a lot of reason to complain because we used to give as high as 200,000, even 500,000 during the times na wala pa kaming taxes. Now, you'll be lucky to get 50,000, 20 to 50 yung maximum.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Number of questions?
Relevant questions, please.
Topel Pelayo of DWI.
Sir, nabanggit po ninyo na 900 billion na lang po, million yung fund na lang po for charity. Bakit po bumaba, sir, from 9 billion?
Well, as I've said, we have the taxes that weren't there before, you know, yung documentary stamps, VAT, no? We have the earmarking, malasakit, also the universal healthcare law, no? Although they're the same, pareho naman ang ginagawa nila. Yung mga like National Book Development Board, things that have nothing to do with our mandate, naka-automatic earmarking po sa amin yun. May sports din. So, we're working on it though para yung wala namang relationship po sa charity ay matanggal, no? Because ang laki ho na nawawala na sa amin for the taxes that we pay. So, not only do we give charity, we also are a revenue generation for the government.
Okay, thank you. And now we will proceed to the handing over of the 2.5 billion check of PCAO to PhilHealth. Taas na lang. Hindi makita. Sige. Taas na lang. Sorry. Okay. Thank you po, PCSO General Manager Mel Robles at sa ating pong PhilHealth Spokesperson, Dr. Shirley Gigi Domingo. Maraming salamat po.